Impedance. It's easy to write down numbers about it, but how does that actually affect sound? Stick around to the end of this video and you'll be able to answer that question. Hey guys, Tyler here at Alder Audio, and this is a long overdue follow-up to the kind of short technical talk I did on impedance a number of months ago. If you haven't seen that video, it's on the Alder Audio YouTube channel. And in that video, I went into kind of the technical mumbo jumbo of input devices, stuff like preamps or interfaces and their input impedance, and then sources, things like guitar pickups, microphones, and their output impedance number, all measured in ohms, and how the interaction between those two things can change your sound from like a technical standpoint. In this video, I'm going into what that actually sounds like. And it can have a lot of variety to it. And so some things are very subtle, some things are very obvious. We're gonna start on the obvious end. Before we get going, this is also definitely a mandatory headphones or speakers, good speakers type of situation if you wanna hear these differences. But to start, to show what a mismatch in impedance, what kind of problems it can cause in your sound, I picked the kind of most blatantly obvious situation, and that's where you've got a piezo pickup on an acoustic instrument like this guitar. I've got a little stick-on piezo over here, and these are notorious for having a very high output impedance, so like up in the range of a mega ohm, so 1,000,000 ohms. And then I'm plugging this into a little line array here. This is a JBL Eon 1, and it has an input impedance of 40,000 ohms. And so usually you want that flipped. You want the thing you're plugging into to have the higher number and the source to have the lower number. So in this case, we've got a mismatch the other way, and you're gonna hear how detrimental this can be on your sound. And when the sources are really far apart, it has a much bigger effect. So this is, to me, the quintessential place where impedance mismatch can really sound terrible. So I'm going to give you two samples here, recorded with a room mic, one direct into the line array, and one with a preamp in between that takes care of that impedance mismatch. And you can hear the difference between those. Here we go. All right, so that was an example of a really extreme mismatch, and I can tell you, as bad as that sound sounded recorded with a room mic, it sounded way worse in the actual room. A piezo directly in to any kind of preamp is like physically painful. It's really bad. And again, that's because we're at 1,000,000 ohms on our source, our pickup, and we're at 40,000 ohms on the input that we're plugging into, and we want those to be kind of the other way around. But most people, that's not the situation they're worried about when they're trying to research impedance, and that's kind of not why I made the technical video. For a lot of people, we're talking about plugging microphones or pickups into things like preamps. And in that case, it's a much more subtle kind of difference, and I want you to be able to hear that as well. So the way we're going to do that is just through one source. I'm going to record a guitar amp. So I've got a Supro Blues King here, and I'm just going to be looping a riff, and we're going to record it all with one of my ribbon mics. This is the Alder H44. I make all of these myself. You can grab them at alderaudio.com for $400. They're fantastic. But the output impedance of this is 400 ohms. And then what we're going to be plugging this into is a variable Z booster. This is what they call the Cloudlifter Z. So you're probably familiar with Cloudlifters if you're into recording. It's a mic booster, it just adds clean gain. But this version of the Cloudlifter has this big fat knob on the front where you can adjust the impedance up and down. So we're gonna be running a loop, and the first thing that I'm gonna do is to just you know, play the loop and sweep this knob so that you hear what happens when it goes from all the way at the top, which is 15K, 15,000 ohms, all the way to the bottom, which is 150 ohms. All right, so let's hear what that sounds like. So what's going on here? Is this big knob at the center just a volume knob? You know, clearly we're going up and down in volume. And if you'd listen to the technical talk on the channel, this shouldn't be all that surprising. As the impedance goes down, you start to reflect voltage, and you start to reflect voltage across the whole spectrum, so you lose volume. But you're going to lose more in the low end than the high end. It's just that, you know, it's really hard to tell how much we're actually changing the tone. Because, you know, if you've been in audio a while, you know if things aren't level matched, you really have no hope in comparing apples to apples. And so what we really need to do to be able to evaluate how is this affecting our tone is to test it at what I'm going to do is the highest, 15K input impedance, and then test it at the lowest, 150 ohms. And level match the two of them, okay? And then we'll be able to get a sense of what changes in tone is this actually causing in the mic, not just volume, because that's obviously going on, but what changes in tone are going on. All right, so let's do that and take a listen. So I think you will agree with me that that difference is incredibly subtle. I think that most people would struggle to even hear a difference between those two, especially if you're not listening on a great system or headphones. I don't know through YouTube if everything is going to come through accurately, but there is a difference. It's important. It's especially when you get more and more professional, it's good to pay attention to those subtle things. But what I really want to speak to is that people ask me questions all the time, like, can I use X preamp with my ribbon mic, or is this impedance okay for that mic? And by and large, the answer is yes. Use your preamp. Go ahead. It's good to be aware of what's going on. So if there's a little low end, you know, kind of factor, it does matter. But, you know, a preamp mismatch with your microphone is just never going to be nearly as big as that 1 mega ohm versus 40 kilo ohm difference that we saw with the acoustic guitar. In this case, you know, we've got 400 ohms, and which ideally you should have an input of 4,000 or above. But 400 ohms versus 150 ohms input impedance, it's just not that big. And you can see that the detriment to the low end is pretty subtle. Now, as for these kind of switching options, or like this Cloudlifter Z variable box, I do think these things are still useful. One thing they can be useful for is cutting out noise floor. If you're using a ribbon mic as a room mic, sometimes there's a rumble in the background. I know my mic have a really big low end, and so that can be a problem. And when you tune down to 300 or down to the 150, it definitely cuts out that rumble, and that's pretty helpful. Plus, I like some of the different options they have on this box. I also like preamps that have the switchable impedance. It's just nice to be in control and to know if you have a unique situation, you can react to it. But by and large, I'd say don't make it a deal breaker. Don't make it like, I can't use this preamp with this mic. It's really a very subtle thing when it comes to microphones and input impedance to preamps or boosters like this. So I really hope that helps. I hope that helps you get some like real sound reference for what these things sound like. Really appreciate you stopping by. If you're curious about my mics, go check out alderaudio.com, and I hope you make some music today. Thanks.